Hi, Mom. I brought you a cup of coffee.
Why, Sandy, thank you, dear.
I'd like to talk to you, Mom.
Go ahead, dear.
I'm pregnant.
Oh my God. No.
Mark, I need you.
Oh, Sandy, how could you do this to me?
What happened?
I told her I'm pregnant.
Dear Lord, give me wisdom.
Your father will go out of his mind. Our good name is ruined. I can't face the church. Oh, where have we gone wrong?
I've got to call your father. Mother, can't it wait? No, he should know. Well, at least I'm getting some attention.
Meanwhile, down in the office.
Mr. Miller, I'm having problems with my daughter. She's Sandy's age. Is Sandy rebellious?
Not at all. You see, we raised her the right way. Excuse me, Ruth, the phone. Good morning, Frank Miller speaking.
Sandy's pregnant!
I'll be gone for the rest of the day, Ruth.
Yes, Mr. Miller. Oh, how I envy them. Their home must be like heaven.
Where's that dirty little tramp? I said, where is she?
Frank, calm down. We're intelligent adults. She's in the den with Mark.
Does he know about it?
Yes.
Don't we have any privacy anymore? I have one question for you, young lady. Who's the animal that got to you? What's his name?
I don't know, Daddy.
You mean you were raped, Sandy? Why didn't you tell us? Was he a stranger? Did he threaten you if you told? I'll kill him.
Daddy, it was one of the boys at church.
Which one? That's the problem. I don't know. A deathly silence settles over the room.
I'm sorry, Mom and Dad. Mark has been talking to me. I've asked God to forgive me, and I want you to forgive me too.
I can't. Blast it, I'll never forgive you for humiliating your mother and me like this. Excuse me for butting in, Frank. What would it be like if Christ wouldn't forgive us?
That's got nothing to do with this.
I'm sorry, Frank, but it has everything to do with this. If he didn't forgive us, then we'd all be going to the lake of fire. Frank, you have to forgive Sandy. Do you remember the scripture, Frank? Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Till 7 times? I say not unto thee until 7 times, but until 70 times 7.
Yeah, I remember. 2 hours later.
We're sorry, Sandy. We do forgive you.
We'll try to work this out together, Sandy. I know this is a very delicate situation, but I'm only trying to help. Let's assume the baby is on the way. Are you going to keep it, Sandy?
I don't know.
Don't be ridiculous. Of course she isn't. I feel it should be handled this way. First of all, we have to keep the whole thing hush hush. I know a doctor who can perform an abortion over in Valeview.
But Daddy, why abortion?
Because the Supreme Court has made it legal. But Frank, that's murder. But it isn't a person until it takes its first breath. The Bible says John the Baptist was filled with the Holy Spirit when he was only 6 months in Elizabeth's womb. God also said to Jeremiah, "Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee, and before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations." I'd like to read a little story to you. December 16th, today my life began. My parents do not know it yet. I am as small as a seed of an apple, but it is I already, and I am to be a girl. I shall have blonde hair and azure eyes. Just about everything is settled, though, even the fact that I shall love flowers. December 21st. Some say that I am not a real person yet, that only my mother exists, but I am a real person just as a small crumb of bread is yet truly bread. My mother is, and I am. December 28th. My heart began to beat today, all by itself. From now on, it shall gently beat for the rest of my life without ever stopping to rest. And after many years, it will tire. It will stop, and then I shall die. January 7th. I am growing a bit every day. My arms and legs are beginning to take shape. But I have to wait a long time yet before those little legs will raise me to my mother's arms, before these little arms will be able to gather flowers and embrace my father. January 16th. Tiny fingers are beginning to form on my hands. Funny how small they are. I shall be able to stroke my mother's hair with them, and I shall take her hair to my mouth, and she will probably say, "Oh, no, no, dear." January 21st. It wasn't until today that the doctor told Mom that I am living here under her heart. Oh, Mom, how happy she must be. Are you happy, Mom? January 25th. My mom and dad are probably thinking about a name for me, but they don't even know that I'm a girl. They are probably saying Andy, but I want to be called Kathy. I am getting so big already. February 24th. I wonder if Mom hears the whisper of my heart. Some children come in the world a little sick, and when the delicate hands of the doctor performs miracles to bring them to health, it beats so evenly. Thump, thump, thump. You'll have a healthy little daughter, Mom. February 28th. Today, my mother killed me. Oh, how horrible! Isn't it funny? Everybody yells for human rights, but the baby doesn't have any. That settles it. If I can't keep the baby, then it will go to a Christian home for adoption. Why don't we pray about it tonight and talk it over tomorrow? Next morning.
Mama, I've got great news. Guess what? It was a false alarm.
Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you.